We're gathered here today to celebrate the making of the first ceremonial haggis, which is going to be used in the Great Haggis Pass on January the 24th.
6 weeks ago, Linda told us in class that Stuart Cohen had asked if some of the students could design a haggis for the Great Haggis Pass. So we ordered two weather balloons off of Amazon. The first balloon seemed okay, but deflated overnight and discovered it as a hole in it.
Because it was like a parcel going round the world, we would then add brown parcel wrapping paper, which was then embellished with stickers, and the stickers, because they were to look like travel stickers, had Robert Burns's images, and there was excerpts from poems.
The young people who have taken the time to construct this masterpiece have done really well, and what I'm particularly pleased about, I've got to tell you, and this is just my sense of humour, is the fact that it's got a wee hat.
We came up with this idea of the ceremonial haggis, and we were puzzling as who would make it, and as soon as Linda and you guys heard about it, you got even more excited about it than I was. And look at this, it is absolutely amazing.
I think we'll get messages from all over the world. Burns is a worldwide iconic figure. One of his best known poems, if not the best known poem, is the Address to the Haggis.
Fair fall your honest sonsy face, great chief know the pudding race. Aboon the wa' ye tak your place, pain stripe a firm.
If we can get people to send us letters, cards, or even emails wishing Robert Burns a happy birthday, send them to the Robert Burns Birthplace Museum or email them to the Burns website, burns@nts. And we'll put all these messages inside this phenomenal haggis. The people of Ayr and Ayrshire will move it on the day, hand by hand, round the town and the village, and then we'll have it on display for his birthday on the 25th.